Live from the Fastener TV studios, it's In the News with Fastener News Desk.
Thank you, Chris. I'm Lisa Kleinhandler, Editor-in-Chief at Fastener News Desk. Here's what's happening in fastener industry news, acquisitions, association events, and scholarship opportunities the week of May 1st, 2023. AFC Industries has acquired Arlington, Texas-based QFC Industries. Terms of the deal were not disclosed. Founded in 1973 as Quickway Fastener Company and later rebranded as QFC, the company is a distributor of fasteners and other small components to a diverse group of manufacturing and assembly customers in the United States, Mexico, Europe, and China. Headquartered in Fairfield, Ohio, AFC Industries is a dynamic organization dedicated to providing supply chain management solutions for fasteners, tooling, and assembly components to original equipment manufacturers, assembly plants, and other users of these products. In 2021, AFC was acquired by private equity firm Bertram Capital. NASA has demonstrated a breakthrough in 3D printable high-temperature materials that could lead to stronger, more durable parts for airplanes and spacecraft. A team of innovators from NASA and The Ohio State University detailed the characteristics of the new alloy, GRX-810, in a peer-reviewed paper published in the journal Nature. This superalloy has the potential to dramatically improve the strength and toughness of components and parts used in the aviation and space exploration, said Dr. Tim Smith of NASA's Glenn Research Center in Cleveland. Congratulations go out to TR Fastenings as they celebrated their 50th anniversary at the recent Fastener Fair Global. TR Fastenings is part of TriFast and is an international specialist in design, engineering, manufacture, and distribution of industrial fastenings and Category C components, principally to major global assembly industries. Wishing them all the best for the next 50. The North Coast Fastener Association's 14th Annual Distributor Social is happening this Thursday, May 4th in Independence, Ohio from 5 to 8 p.m. The Distributor Social is the largest networking event for the fastener industry in Cleveland and the surrounding areas. The NCFA Distributor Social brings together many of the top distributors and supplier companies in the industry to network and socialize while enjoying drinks, appetizers, and desserts. The event continues to draw hundreds of attendees each year because of its simplicity. The NCFA Distributor Social is just that, a time to be social with current and potential customers and industry friends in a more casual setting than a traditional fastener show. Register now at ncfaonline.com. The National Fastener Distributors Association and the Young Fastener Professional Association will be hosting a virtual roundtable, The Triple Bottom Line, People, Planet, and Profit, on Thursday, May 11th at 2 p.m. Eastern. Rethink the way you measure success with discussion on Triple Bottom Line sustainability framework, why it is, why it is important, and how you can implement it. It's free to attend, but registration is required. Go to nfda-fastener.org. Fastener Fair USA is back and better than ever. The highly anticipated trade show is taking place at Music City Center in Nashville, Tennessee from May 16th through the 17th, and it's not one to be missed. This year's event promises to be bigger and better than ever, with new exhibitors, industry-leading products, and a range of educational and networking opportunities. Fastener Fair USA is a unique opportunity for members of the entire fastener supply chain to connect, network, and learn about the latest trends, products, and technologies in the industry. The event features nearly 200 exhibitors showcasing a wide range of products and services, including fasteners, adhesives, assembly tools, and more. Use Fastener News Desk code FND for free registration. Go to FastenerFairUSA.com. How Screws and Bolts Are Made, the Basics of Colt Heading, an upcoming webinar co-produced by the Fastener Training Institute and the Industrial Fasteners Institute, will take place on Friday, May 19th from 12 to 2 p.m. Eastern. Whether you're new to the fastener industry or a seasoned veteran, have you ever wanted to know more about how threaded fasteners are made? Although there are different methods that can be employed, the most common way of forming a fastener is by colt heading. This webinar will introduce participants to a high-level overview of colt heading, its advantages, the colt heading machine process, machine types, as well as descriptions and the tooling necessary to make it all happen. For registration, go to fastenertraining.org. BTM Manufacturing Domestic Fastener Manufacturer is partnering with ISCO Inc., Twin Lakes Insurance, and Wachter Inc. for an upcoming event to help support the good work of the Sleep in Heavenly Peace organization. Help Jake and his team build 100 beds on June 10th. There are a couple of ways to get involved. Either volunteer to help build or donate funds. The cost of the project is $25,000. Donated funds will provide the necessary lumber and hardware to build and assemble the beds, as well as provide the mattresses, pillows, and bedding to make them complete. Every child deserves a warm, soft, and safe place to sleep at night. And with your help, we can see that no kid sleeps on the floor in any town. For more information on how you can help, go to @BTMMFG on Twitter. Together, we can make sure that every child has a bed to sleep in. To learn more about the new series, Fascinating, a limited-time offer celebrating your success, go to Fastener News Group at LinkedIn. Your entry could be chosen for a free feature at Fastener News Desk, which includes premium placement, link to your website, promo in the Fastener News communities, feature in an upcoming newsletter, and featured in the News podcast. Entries may be submitted to lisa@fastenernewsdesk.com. Fastener industry associations offer many great scholarship opportunities. Let's get started with the Metropolitan Fastener Distributors Association accepting applications for their 2023 scholarship. The MFDA is dedicated to representing all segments of the fastener industry. Scholarship applications must be received no later than May 15th. Application can be found at mfda.us. The North Coast Fastener Association is fueling the knowledge of the fastener industry with their 2023 scholarship. The NCFA will be giving away up to $5,000 in scholarships this year. The NCFA scholarship application is available now. Applications must be postmarked by May 31st to be considered. Awards will be notified on July of 2023. Applications are being accepted for the Gilchrist Foundation Fastener Scholarship. Those who received awards are expected upon completion of their schooling to make an earnest effort to work in the fastener industry or pursue employment at a Fastener Industry Trade Association member company. Unlike other scholarships, applications are accepted during any year of a person's schooling. Also, an applicant may be a part-time student currently working in the fastener industry. Applications are due by May 31st. Go to GilchristFoundation.com to apply today. Women in the Fastener Industry Organization is celebrating the life of fastener industry pioneer Marianne Mirzacci, co-founder of Link Magazine, with a $1,500 scholarship that will be awarded to a woman to attend college or trade school. The recipient must have a female family member who is employed by a fastener company. The application deadline is June 5th, 2023. Apply now at fastenerwomen.com/scholarships. The Pacific West Fastener Association is offering a scholarship for Fastener Training Week produced by the Fastener Training Institute, which is valued at $2,800. Only employees of PacWest member companies are eligible. The scholarship is for tuition only for a Fastener Training Week in either 2023 or 2024 and does not include expenses for travel, lodging, or meals. Fastener Training Week is a robust program that includes 5 intensive days of education and plant tours as part of the acclaimed FTI Certified Fastener Specialist Advanced Technical Training Program. After completing this invaluable industry training in a small group environment and passing a final exam, attendees are then eligible for the CFS designation. To access the application form or request a copy by email, contact Amy at pacpac-west.org. Applications must be submitted by June 30th. Have you tried buying fasteners online? Industrial products are comprehensive, and purchasing them online can lead to poor customer experiences when utilizing filtered search. Buyers are forced to use a multitude of search filters just to find a bolt. Product Genius's grid technology organizes and displays entire product categories from a one-page buying experience. Experience the future of fastener buying online at 1-800-FASTENERS.com. Product Genius technology services also include data cleaning and preparation, consultation and strategizing. Contact a representative at productgeniustechnology.com or call 1-800-FASTENERS to find out how to get started today. The stories featured in this week's episode of In the News can be found at Fastener News Desk or in our Twitter feed at Fastener News or on LinkedIn in the Fastener News Group. If you'd like to share your company's events, news, or sponsor an upcoming episode of In the News, or you'd like to add to the Fastener Museum, contact me, Lisa at FastenerNewsDesk.com. Thanks for tuning in to this week's episode of In the News with Fastener News Desk. Until next week, be well, be safe, and keep it fascinating.